Now let's revisit why we are looking at permutation matrices. We want to look at permutation matrices because as we are doing an LU factorization, we may have ended up in this particular situation right here where we have already processed the previous columns and now we're concentrating on this column right here. We want to use this row in order to annihilate or to place zeros in the entries below the diagonal element. But we may run into the situation where alpha 1, 1 is exactly equal to 0, so we would end up dividing by 0. Or alpha 1, 1 in magnitude is very small, so that it acts like a 0, and that itself, we're going to see, can lead to trouble down the line. The way we are going to swap rows is actually to go and find the value amongst these entries right here that is largest in magnitude. And the reason for that is going to become clear. Just not yet. So, once we find the value with largest magnitude, then that's the row that we swap with the row that is currently at the top. Now notice that that means that we're not permuting all of these entries and therefore all of these rows. We're really looking for a very special case of a permutation that swaps two rows. Okay? And the vehicle there is going to be something slightly simpler. So when we get to this point, what we want is we want a permutation matrix, and we're going to call it P tilde, that given an integer relative to this vector swaps the row that is relative to this row, so counting this row as being row 0, this integer tells us which row amongst these rows to swap. Okay? So that matrix actually has a very special form. That matrix P tilde of pi, now let's just say of any integer, is given by, well, you'll have a 1 in the column indexed with pi. You'll have the, an identity for the rest here. Then you'll have another 1 here, that is in the first spot, and then you have the identity here. Because what does this do? This here goes and picks out the entry, when applied to a vector, the entry indexed with pi and places it in the first position. It leaves the next bunch of entries alone. When it then gets to the row indexed with pi, or the entry indexed with pi, it replaces it with the first entry in the vector, and then it leaves the remainder of that vector alone again. So it swaps just two, and that means that if you apply it to a matrix, it swaps those two rows. Alright? And this actually is going to become the vehicle that we are going to use as we further discuss LU factorization with row pivoting, or partial pivoting as some people would call it.